Hi friends, please like, subscribe and share my YouTube channel.
Hi, welcome everyone. In this lecture, we will talk about domain flipping. Domain flipping simply means buying domains at a lower price and selling them at a higher price. The difference between these prices is your profit. The best thing about domain flipping is it has very low investment and profit can be very very huge. For example, carinsurance.com was sold in 2010 at a price of $49.7 million, and there are many other domains that worth millions of dollars. You can also buy any available domain and you never know, maybe you can sell it at a very higher price. Most important thing is that you can buy a single domain at just around $10. That means if you can invest $100 to $200, then you will be having 10 to 20 domains. Now, if any one of your domain will be sold at more than $200, then you are covering the cost of all domains that you bought and also getting the profit. The first thing you need to do to flip domains is choosing a profitable niche, and the best way to do it is searching for niches in Google Trends and analyze the demand. Suppose you find that natural remedies for stomach problems is a profitable niche, so you should start searching for domains that will be easy to remember. This is very important to invest time in your research, because this research will be the base for your success in domain flipping. I suggest you always choose .com extension, and remember that short domains are usually more preferred. Also, you should try choosing great business names that people might be searching for. You will have to understand the value of your domain and consider these questions to set its price. Think about who might buy your domain, how much profit can be earned using that domain, how much money will be invested in advertising the domain, whether it is a large business domain name or a small business domain name. These are some example questions you must consider before setting the sale price of your domain. I would recommend that you should understand the business behind the domain and research about the investments and profits of that business. In this way, you will be able to set a perfect price at which you should sell that domain. For example, a local business domain for a particular city should not be priced higher, and an international business domain must have a higher price. Now, how to promote your domains? There are many domain selling sites where you can list your domains, but I would recommend Flippa, Seedo, Huge Domains and GoDaddy, because these sites have huge number of buyers and sellers. There is one more way to promote your domain, that is join Facebook groups in your niche. For example, you buy domains for online education industry, then you should try to join all business groups that are related to education industry if you find any. Just make sure that these groups are business groups, not educational groups. Now you can promote your domains there. It is not an easy task to get great domains, but if you spend enough time on learning this art, then you will succeed at it. Initially, it will be difficult for sure, but it takes time to learn anything. Buying great domains is a skill that will take some time. You just need to have patience. Don't just go and start buying the domains. It would be better if you study about it through YouTube and blogs, then enter into this industry. It might be the case that you won't be able to sell some of your domains, and some domains might take years. So you will have to wait and keep buying great domains. If you really want to do this, I wish you become a millionaire. Thanks everyone. I will see you at the next lecture. Hi, welcome everyone. In this lecture, we will discuss the advantages and the disadvantages of flipping domains. Let's start with the advantages. The first advantage is you don't need any experience to flip domains. As you know that flipping domains is just buying domains and selling them, you don't need to have experience to do it. The second advantage is you don't need hard drive storage or cloud storage to store domain names. The third advantage is you don't need coding skills. Many people think that they cannot enter into website business if they do not have any coding skills, which is not true. Practically, you don't need to have coding skills to start selling domains. The fourth advantage is there is no shipping cost associated with selling a domain to any buyer. You will just need to transfer your domain to the buyer. Also, you don't need to worry about the domain once it is transferred. Since domains are not actual products that are created, hence buyer will not ask you for any help after the sale. Now let's discuss the disadvantages. The first disadvantage is it requires investment. If you want to start selling domains, then you have to buy them. Although this cost is not very high, but if you don't buy quality domains and don't make any sales, then you will face loss. The second and the last disadvantage is it is time taking. You cannot start buying and selling domains just like that. You will have to do proper research with having your prospective buyer in your mind. I hope you will keep these advantages and disadvantages in mind when you start flipping domains. Thanks everyone. I will see you at the next lecture. Hi, welcome everyone. In this lecture, I will give you some profitable domain ideas. The first idea is, if you want to buy domains for a specific geographical location, then it must have the name of the location, like newyork.com or england.com. The second idea is, if you want to buy domains for online learning platform, then I suggest you use quality word in the domain if possible, like qualitytesting.com if you want to teach testing skills, or qualityk12.com if you want to teach school students. This is my personal advice because people tend to like things that offer quality. Therefore, if you will have quality word in your domain name, then more people are likely to prefer your domain. The third idea is, if you want to buy domains in technology, then try to search for current technologies that are in demand or that are likely to be in demand. The fourth idea is, if you want to buy domains for future events, then search for previous events and the websites for those events. For example, you can check previous Olympic event websites to understand what type of domain names are registered by Olympic organizers. You can buy similar domains and try to connect with the organizers to close the deal. This is not restricted to Olympics. There are many events that happen around the world. Also, you can search for industry-wise trends in Google search trends, then buy the domains that you think is more likely to be in demand. Thanks everyone. I will see you at the next lecture.